With Elizabeth II's death, Brunei's Sultan Hassan al-Bolkiah becomes the world's longest reigning monarch. The 76-year-old Sultan ascended the throne of the Muslim country back in 1967, which makes his reign a total of 54 years so far. He comes from a family that has ruled the country for over 600 years and is one of the richest people on the planet. Denmark's Queen Margaret II, meanwhile, becomes Europe's longest serving monarch, following the death of the renowned queen. At 82 years old, Queen Margaret II has been hailed for unifying and modernizing the monarchy in her 50 years on the throne. King Charles III gives his first public address since his mother, Queen Elizabeth's death, ahead of his formal proclamation as Britain's new monarch. In his speech, he vowed to emulate his late mother's life of service.
I speak to you today with feelings of profound sorrow. Throughout her life, Her Majesty the Queen, my beloved mother, was an inspiration, an example to me and to all my family. And we owe her the most heartfelt debt any family could owe to their mother, for her love, affection, guidance, understanding, and example. Queen Elizabeth was a life well lived, a promise with destiny kept, and she is mourned most deeply in her passing. That promise of lifelong service I renew to you all today. Alongside the personal grief that all my family are feeling, we also share with so many of you in the United Kingdom, in all the countries where the Queen was head of state, in the Commonwealth and across the world, a deep sense of gratitude for the more than 70 years in which my mother, as Queen, served the people of so many nations.
Aside from paying tribute to his mother, King Charles also bared his son William's new title as the now heir apparent and expressed love for his other son, Harry, and his wife, Meghan.
As my heir, William now assumes the Scottish titles, which have meant so much to me. He succeeds me as Duke of Cornwall and takes on the responsibilities for the Duchy of Cornwall, which I have undertaken for more than five decades. Today, I am proud to create him Prince of Wales, Tywysog Cymru, the country whose title I've been so greatly privileged to bear during so much of my life and duty. With Catherine beside him, our new Prince and Princess of Wales will, I know, continue to inspire and lead our national conversations, helping to bring the marginal to the center ground where vital help can be given. I want also to express my love for Harry and Meghan as they continue to build their lives overseas. And to my darling mama, as you begin your last great journey to join my dear late papa, I want simply to say this: thank you. Thank you for your love and devotion to our family and to the family of nations you have served so diligently all these years.
Charles will be formally proclaimed king at 11 Saturday morning. That's around 6 in the evening, Manila. At 73 years old, he will be the oldest monarch yet to ascend the throne. The proclamation will be held at St. James Palace in London in front of a ceremonial body known as the Accession Council, which is largely made up of privy councillors or senior politicians that formally advise the monarch. Flags lowered in mourning for the late queen will fly full mast after the Accession Council, which will also be televised for the first time. A wave of proclamations will also be held across UK until Sunday, when flags will return to half mast. The gates of Buckingham Palace in London overflowing with flowers as thousands pay their respects to the Queen. Today is the first day of national mourning in Britain, which will last until the late monarch's state funeral on September 19. The Ministry of Defense held 96 rounds of gun salutes in all four nations of the UK and on board Royal Navy ships at sea in honor of the Queen's age. Before addressing the nation for the first time, King Charles III traveled to Buckingham Palace, where he met with well-wishers gathered outside. He also met with UK Prime Minister Liz Truss. A historian now says the British monarchy is entering a new era. Professor Xiao Chua believes with King Charles III taking over the throne, Britain can expect a more progressive future.
Si Charles parang magiging progressive king. Tinatanggap niya yung mga iba-ibang reliyon, yung multicultural siya, no? At climate change, gusto niyang kalabanin. Yung mga homeless, yung mga medyo addict, no? Yung mga wala nang ano, kinabukasan sa lipunan na sinasabi nila, ay kinupkup nila yon at ginawa ng mga oportunidad para makapasok muli sa lipunan. So napaka-progressive actually ni Charles bilang isang prinsipe. At yun na nga, inaasahan na nakikita na ito ng marami, nag-mature na siya sa role niya.